So this was the first date that you guys hosted. Can you tell me a little bit more about that? Like, what did it feel like for you guys to do that?
Can I tell you that some of these things that we got to do were like bucket list for me? Like saying this is the final rose, I was like, check that off the bucket list. Like, never thought that would happen. And hosting a date, it was just so fun because I think we were able to be extra sets of eyes for Katie, where we were like, oh, look how they're interacting, or why aren't they talking to each other? And we were able to help her, like, have more eyes on the guys, and
Yeah.
not in a creepy way, in a way where we were like genuinely trying to help her. And it's fun. It's just so fun being a part of those dates and hosting and seeing it all and not feeling that pressure that, like, we have to be, there for the guys. We were able to just be like, here's how it's going to go down. We're watching you. And then give out a buckle or a gloat trophy.
A
It was
trophy. So much more fun hosting the date.
so
It's
fun.
so much more fun because you can like poke fun and like make jokes and like, I don't know,
Yeah, it
enjoy
was
yourself.
no
Katie was
pressure.
the one like, yeah, exactly. There was no pressure
No
at all.
pressure. And fun to be like, it really felt like we were hanging out with girlfriends. Like, it
Yeah.
didn't feel like conversations the other, if there was just like, I'm trying to think of if there was, yeah, like in the past, like Wells, when he came in and did the hosted dates or something, or they do the little banter or the commentary. It felt different from that because we were able to be like girlfriends hanging out, being like, okay, look at him, or watch how we were able to kind of see and put ourselves in her position and help her in that way, rather than just being like, oh, look at that guy being an idiot.
Look at that
And
guy
we
being
actually
an
we
idiot.
also
like saw these guys like come out of the limo, and so we actually
Yeah.
could we knew their names,
Yeah.
we knew a little bit about them, like, oh, like he's acting a little different. Like, do you notice that? As opposed to
Right.
like, so give me the lowdown about like what's happening here. Who are you kind of into? And it's just really different
Yeah, it
having
was
girlfriends that are actually present.
now that we're into
totally.
week two, three guys got roses this week. Was there anyone that you felt that you were surprised that didn't get a rose?
Did Andrew S. get a rose? He
I was just
did.
gonna say the same thing.
He
Andreas
did.
did get a rose. He was
Oh, he
the
did.
only person.
No, there was Thomas. No.
Who got a rose?
No.
Thomas got a
Oh, can we
rose.
talk about Thomas and like when
Thomas
they
got a
had
rose.
they
I
had a makeout
honestly, he's
scene?
Mr.
Thomas got a rose
Likes
on the date,
on the
huh?
first group date. And then Greg on his one-on-one date. And then Andrew in the last group date, which was, I mean, he stepped in and he
Okay,
basically.
Connor B should have gotten a rose.
I
But
yes, he's
I
amazing.
will say how he said, I'm good with my fingers. And then did you see him making out with her? He was like, ah, like on her head. And I was like, that is not being great with your fingers, but
No, he wanted to do it again because his paws were everywhere and he's like, my hands were so awkward. And the next thing you know, she's like,
it was like he didn't know what to do without the paws. Like, he was like, is this how I do it? But Mike, you were saying something about Thomas's makeout session. That was aggressive.
I just saw
She's into
Spanx.
him.
I saw Spinks.
I saw the Spanx hanging out. I saw Katie, like, if you watch it again in slow-mo, you will see Katie looking down at his lips. Like she wanted those lips.
Yeah.
I don't know if y'all caught that part. It was a makeout session. It was a makeout session. Katie.
We had no idea that makeout went down like that until we just watched the episode. So we
Yeah.
were just
It went
like,
down.
excuse me, I
We
did not
went
know it was
down.
getting down
We
like that
were
at group
not
dates.
peeping through the window on that one. No. No.
Talking about peeping through the window, Kaitlyn, I need some tea now. You gotta give me some tea. What? Well, tell me some behind the scenes that took place on the Buckle Brawl date.
Well, Tayshia and I definitely got in the mud after. No, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. I'm trying to think of what happened. Like, I was too busy like playing with the horses on the sidelines.
Feel that. I love my
Yes.
horses.
I was obsessed with that golden horse. I don't know. I feel like, oh, you know what's interesting is they didn't show this, but I think it's worth talking about that Cody and Aaron,
Aaron. Yeah,
you know,
Aaron.
they had the beef and they fought. They remember Cody actually came back and wanted to fight him again.
Yes,
What, like
he
the mud during the
actually
mud?
said on the date he did come back.
Yeah,
He
he's
said,
like,
I
I would
want a
like to do that
rematch.
again.
There you go, boy. There, I like that. I like the testosterone. Let's go.
So that's confusing to me. So you want to fight him again on the date, but you don't want to stand up for yourself when Katie puts you on the spot. spot.
Bibi, it's because he lied.
Yeah.
No,
yeah.
I don't know. I just don't think that he had the cojones to. I don't know if you guys know. I just, like,
is that balls?
Yeah.
We know cojones.
Balls, guys.